Hello everyone, this is Life Around Science and this is a flip through of the book Sears and Szymanski's University Physics with Modern Physics. We will be looking at the 13th edition. The authors are Young, Friedman and Ford. It offers problem-solving challenges which are not addressed in other texts. It offers a research-based problem-solving approach. It also lets you know about problem-solving strategies using figures and explanatory annotations. There are different caution paragraphs which we will see which help clear some common misconceptions. There are end-of-section test your understanding questions and visual summaries at the end of each chapter. So let's have a look at this book. As we see, it covers a vast number of topics like mechanics, waves, acoustics, thermodynamics, electromagnetism, optics, modern physics, which are the main chapters and sections this book is divided into. It has further chapters in there, and these are very key, especially if you see in the modern physics bit. Relativity is again a whole subject of its own when you go to higher studies. Quantum mechanics is a whole subject. Atomic structure is a subject. Nuclear physics is another subject. So this is very well divided into sections. Yu Young is Emeritus Professor of Physics at Carnegie Mellon University. Roger Friedman is a lecturer in physics at the University of California. Lewis Ford is a professor of physics at Texas A&M University. This is a more detailed index. So we have the name of the section here, the name of the chapter here. If the chapter is units, physical quantities and vectors, for example, the various sections that appear underneath are outlined here. These are key concepts, for example, displacement time and average velocity in straight line, projectile motion, free body diagrams is a section in this. So frictional forces. So even the key concepts which will be useful for you to study as a student are outlined. And this is a in-depth index. This is the beginning of the first chapter, which is the mechanics section. As you can see, most of the chapters begin with a real life situation. It is very interesting to see as a student how this is related with the topic of the chapter. They also give some learning goals at the beginning. This is the caution, which we were talking about. This caution section, finding the direction of a vector from its component. So paragraphs like these really help you in not making common silly mistakes when you're working with physics examples. These are key hacks used in physics that go a long way in clarifying your concepts and making sure you're not confusing them with other similar concepts. This is a page in which you have an example. So an example with changing acceleration. This is the problem here. And this is where they have outlined how one can go about solving that problem. So they've divided it into sections. One was identify and set up. They've set up the problem, then execute. This is that execute section. And final is evaluate, where you plug in the values and calculate your final answer. And also try to interpret it and make more conceptual understanding out of the problem, which I think is the eventual aim of all numerical problems. So this seems like the end of the chapter, and this is where we have a visual summary which was written and a bridging problem which you can see. The bridging problem you have an identify and setup, execute and evaluate again, but it's not completely solved for you. Then it's full of problems, exercises, lots of exercises. So one can really test their conceptual understanding which gets developed as you go on solving these problems, and then challenge problems. This is the final test your understanding question, which makes use of all the concepts which have been covered in the chapter. So let's jump ahead. Diagrams again. This is an interesting image of rotational motion in a bacteria. So they have related the concept of rotation with constant angular acceleration with how this is used in real life by Escherichia coli bacteria. This, I think, is what sets this book apart, is how excellently it relates physics to day-to-day life, and physics stops seeming something like a subject that you have to study, but starts seeming more like a part of your life and the world that you live in. The fluid mechanics concepts begins with an image of a shark. For example, they ask interesting questions like, the shark must swim constantly to keep from sinking to the bottom of the ocean. Yet the orange tropical fish can remain at the same level in the water with little effort. Why is there a difference? And that stirs and motivates the student to get to know more about this concept and try and answer this question and understand the world around you much better. Mm. This is waves and interference, boundary conditions and superposition, which they have explained in a series of examples. The diagrams that they have provided are helpful in developing your intuition or feel for the concept. This again is end of chapter summary and a bridging problem. This is where they've discussed gas on Jupiter's moon Europa. This is a chapter on resistance, magnetic field and magnetic forces and how they are used in real life applications like magnetic resonance imaging in hospital industry. I remember when I was reading this book, the explanation given in such lucid language that it stopped seeming like I was studying and felt like I was reading an excellently interesting book, which was not at all very difficult for me to understand. And it almost gives you a feel as if you're interacting with the environment around you, and it is based on the concept of contextual learning. So it makes you curious and then it answers the question, which I think is a very natural way for learning. This is relativity, photons, quantum mechanics, atomic structure. They have given a real life photograph of a physicist when he's working on his desk who received a Nobel Prize for his work on block theory. They've also related it to different subjects. So it doesn't stay limited to physics, but they've also related it to concepts in chemistry and real life examples in biology and other subjects. So I think this is especially useful in today's age where multidisciplinary sciences is becoming a large thing and students are more and more expected to be able to draw relations between seemingly disconnected topics. This part is on particle physics and cosmology and goes all the way up to electroweak unification and grand unified theories and supersymmetric theories, which I ended up reading during my PhD graduate school. So it is obviously very useful for 11th, 12th and BSc students, but is also capable of being useful for certain topics for MSc students also. And I referred to it even during my PhD. So this is the end of the chapter with the summary. As you can see, the final section in this book is the beginning of time. And we've reached the appendices. Yes, this is a slightly tricky part with this book, is key concepts like surface tension is something you will not find in the main index. So you may feel that this is not there in the book, but it has been included in the appendices. So surface tension is there, viscosity is there, black body radiation is also in an appendix. They have provided answers to select problems just so you can check whether you have solved them correctly. And then it ends with the appendix, which is extremely detailed, by the way. It is very useful in navigating through the book. So this was a flip through of the 13th edition of University Physics. If you have anything to say, you can put it in the comment section down below. Thank you. We'll be right back.